what is best in life. Well, today we are joining episode 9 of the Zoroastrian Restoration, in which I attempt, starting as a Zoroastrian count in the Abbasid Empire, to restore the Persian Empire as a Zoroastrian kingdom and declare myself the Seoshant, or the one of the three saviors of the Seoshant religion. There is one Seoshant for each 1,000 years at the end of times. And then as Emperor of Persia, I will try to make myself Emperor of Rajasthan, where many Zoroastrians fled into India to form new communities and new heresies of Zoroastrianism. And today, there are actually more Zoroastrians living in India than there are in Persia itself. So, it's a matter of finding some weaknesses. I also, as a character, have cancer, which is reducing my health by -3. I have successful treatment, but only until 797. And I have the stressed characteristic, which I'm trying to remove, which gives me -4. And my treatment only gives me +3. And that will last to 1797. And I won't be able to treat the same illness again. Dining with my wife, the topic of my research came up. I told her, of course, I regret any ill feelings she may be experiencing from it. I'm stargazing again from last episode. I've been doing a lot of stargazing in the hopes of building an observatory. But then I learned by the CK2 wiki that an observatory doesn't come through the Hermetic Society in stargazing, which I thought it did. It actually comes through the scholarship focus. So as this character has cancer and is coming to the end of their life, I am trying to build an observatory, and I'm trying to secure the kingdom of Dalen before, of course, I die. And here I am stargazing again. I think I actually have more than one event chain for stargazing. I think I have it as a mission of the Hermetic Society in one event chain, and I just self-selected it. By right-clicking on a portrait in another. And it's going to be 1797, I believe, before I can change my focus away from hunting. But hunting has a chance to remove my stress trait anyway. And my wife is now too old to grant me other children. So, my steward is collecting taxes in Kaswin, or should be collecting taxes in Kaswin, which is the higher paying of my two Silk Road trading posts. But he is in Gargan right now, so I'll switch him over to Kaswin. And you can see, except for my one small Imaret, the rest of the area is surrounded by Zoroastrian heresies, like the Mazdeki and the Manicheans, which I will try to dispatch my Mobad to try to convert from the Mazdekian heresy. He has such a low attempt. If you notice that the moral authority of Zoroastrian is only 18%, none of the holy sites are held or controlled by Zoroastrians, but it is an organized religion, and I believe I am a paragon of virtue. I have a thousand piety. And I'm trying unsuccessfully to check to see the religion of my vassals. And one of my courtiers has become a heretic. I will try to convince him otherwise. And I will gain the patient trait to improve my vassal-like ability. And my court physician has shared the idea. I do not know much about science, but perhaps he is on to something. He has asked for some money to develop his medical theory and write a book on it. Of course, medicine advances all, and I'm relying on my physician to keep me alive through my cancer. and I'm gaining 6.7 gold a month. And if I wait 2 years, that will gain me about 175 gold. So in 795, I would have 350 or so gold. Oh, my dear liege, your penetrating gaze can part. Oh, great, my, I thought I won a claim, but no, it's just my vassal rejecting his heresy. So I have actually access to a chancellor with a slightly higher skill. So I will put him in Galan, seeking to win a claim. And the province of Dihistan, I can actually vassalize. So I have a Casus Belli for Dihistan. I'm looking for a Casus Belli for Galan and Tabriz, if possible. And that would allow me to form the kingdom of Dilan in this lifetime. While in the meeting with the council, I felt a headache from my stargazing. So I can... Wali Najib of Sahib. So I can fire Sina from the council, my steward. However, my steward is better than any other possible alternative, so I will just keep the steward and take the anger. Still observing the night skies, and I'll keep going until the mission ends and I successfully am awarded some esoteric knowledge by the Hermetic Society. And now, yes, this is the Dihistan and Galan. I'm just checking the number of levies that they can raise. So to form the de jure Kingdom of Dilan, I need 51%, so that is three more lands. And conquering Galan would grant me my second de jure duchy title or emirate. I'm already emirate of Tabaristan. Conquering Galan would entitle me to usurp the title of, I think it's emirate of Dilan, or emirate of Galan, sorry. And then I still would have a claim. I need a claim on Tabriz, or I could use the border conflict Casus Belli, which would cost me piety and some gold, and it would anger all the other Muslim rulers in the land. But he also has the 3,000 troops and 146 gold, although if you notice that's declining, the balance is going down by 4 gold pieces a month. That means he's probably hired mercenaries as part of his, and I can declare a border dispute with him and lose 50 piety, which I have plenty of, and 109 gold. So I'm thinking if I could declare all three wars at once and only hire the mercenaries once, I just might have enough gold to become King of Dilan before I die of cancer. As part of my personal life, I recently had a part of my skin removed and found out, gratefully, just this week, that it's not cancerous. So I was quite pleased to discover I don't have cancer, as that is one of the most miserable things that can happen to a person. So again, I'm just calculating my wealth in comparison to the other Emir, or from the other satrap, to figure out around 795 is about when I'll have enough gold to start hiring mercenaries and conquer hopefully all three sheikdoms in one go. And yes, here I am. I gained just 10 esoteric knowledge for all that stargazing. Although that was not the stargazing that was part of the active mission from the Hermetic Society, that was the stargazing that I did on my own. See, I'm still stargazing and observing the night skies on my mission for the Hermetic Society. Is it time I can get my research? No, I'll keep going until I get success and gain some more esoteric knowledge and get successfully completed the mission. And at 2,000 esoteric knowledge, I can rank up as a magus in the society. So I don't really have anything to do for 2 years. Until I'm prepared to declare war, so I'll speed things up a bit. And I'm just trying to raise cash so I can hire my mercenaries once and fight my wars all at once. And hopefully, gain a claim. And and the truce doesn't end until 798. So if I went to war in 795, I'd become a truce breaker. And all the Muslim rulers in the Abbasid Empire would have a negative 25 opinion of me, but I'm dying of cancer, so I would just have to survive until my son takes over the throne. And there's a thieves' guild taking the 25% of the profits of my trading post in Gurgan. I can't recall how these guilds are established. I'm pretty sure I established, making sure that landowners and traders paying their taxes in a timely fashion is a time-consuming task. Lately, my mind has been more occupied with the task of making sure that the stars are in their correct place, rather than that the taxes are in my coffers. I gain more monthly prestige and lose 50 gold. I'll just lose 32 gold. That's too much gold to lose, and I need it for the upcoming war. And again, I'm observing the night sky. I'll keep going. And I was hoping my hunt would remove the stressed trait from my character so that my health would go up one. But no sign of that yet. My liege is negative 9, but my liege has never shown any signs of attacking me, as she avoided me to council. Oh, my friend, Sheik Shaven, has sent me a gift. It is a small puppy, but of the finest pedigree and destined to grow into a great hunting dog. I will accept this gift, plus 1 health. I will turn it down, or I will kill it. I will not kill the puppy. I will accept the gift. And I will name it Hunter, in the hopes that I can go hunting with it. Well, that's gained plus 1 to my health. So, that is equivalent to reducing the stress trait. Now, if I can still reduce the stress trait. And as I am dying, I should see if I can have a child in my last couple of years. So I'm just going to check for another concubine. This is a genius concubine, and yes, she will actually accept me as a concubine. As she's Tengri, she's 34, which is a little old for a concubine, but I'm not going to live that long anyway. And the other concubine, 7, 40 is too old, 6 is too young. She's 34. And hopefully we can have a child before I die in my last 2 or 3 years. One meeting in council, I had a headache due to my stargazing, and I can fire someone else from council, or I can just take Cinna's anger, so I'll just take anger. I won't fire someone else from council. I've decided to accept my suggestion to take Cece as my concubine. My other concubine is 41, and I will set her aside. Hopefully she won't kill me. She won't convert to Zoroastrianism first, so I'll set her aside, and hopefully she won't assassinate me and my family. And so I need, well, I don't need another concubine, but I have an opportunity to have one. My son really likes me. My daughter-in-law is the princess of, oh, look at all the claims that my daughter-in-law has as princess of the Arabian Abbasid Empire. I'm gonna have my son, when he takes over as heir, is going to have claims on all sorts of lands that hopefully he'll be able to exploit. Oh, and the world will not weigh me down anymore. I lose the stress trait. So I'm not sure if that was because of the hunting focus. I think it was, actually. But it doesn't seem to... It doesn't directly relate it in the event change. But I think that was because I took the hunting focus. So I gained a dog, which was plus one health. And I lost the stressed trait, which was negative one health. So now I'm actually at plus four health and negative four health with my cancer. And I'm starry-eyed, so I'm still stargazing and gaining prestige. And no, I will not back your plot. The Emir of Galan, he is my enemy. I'm not going to help him kill people, as probably the next person he'd help kill is me. And I'm up to 364 gold. And he has 234 gold, which is plenty of gold to hire mercenaries. His levies are only 600, which are half of mine, though. It would be nice if he had less gold. I'm still stargazing. I still have a mission to stargaze from the Hermetic Society. There's a Zoroastrian uprising going on. Hopefully it won't involve me. There are two wars that I'm involved in that I don't know much about. The Sultan of Armenia, and oh, it's the Abbasid Empire is a supporting role. Khan Obadiah, my alliance partner, won his war, and he still barely has a positive opinion of me. Oh no, Khan Obadiah loves me. Sent gift, honored alliance, so Obadiah will be my ally when I do go to war. I might need him for the border dispute, especially with the more powerful satrap. I'll see if he has a concubine. Allies are great places to get concubines from. See if my liege has a concubine for me. My liege doesn't have a concubine available for my court. Are there any quick concubines? Oh, there's a quick and attractive concubine. Potential. No, she won't, because she won't accept infidels. My wife, Shayin, is captivated by the grace and strength of the hunting birds and begged me for a bird. How about a buzzard? A falcon will serve you well. 10 gold. Yes, might as well keep my wife from killing me with 10 gold for a falcon. So what religions will accept concubines? She's strong. Faramaz has published the results of his book and his medical investigations. The book has not received any notable attention, but at least Faramaz developed his skills as a physician. He gained one learning, which should be helpful to me. And no, the Orthodox faith won't be a concubine. How about a Jane? Jane is too young. The Miaphysite faith won't accept concubines. Sheikh Shaban has been very cold to me lately. When I approached him about it today, he asked me point blank where I was when I responded. We had plans to visit my uncle, the one who likes fishing. I knew you weren't all that excited, but I didn't expect you simply not to show up, he mutters. I don't even know who this guy is. I have had more important things on my mind lately, and I'll gain a buff to my stargazing. Yeah, I don't know who this guy is. Grand Vizier of Us at the Arzog. So I'll become a stellar navigator, I think. Or no, I'll just take the anchor. I don't want to piss off foreign enemies in case they invade me. And again, I'll try this concubine. No. Observing the night skies, I'll keep going. She's 9, there's a 16-year-old, she's 20, she's some kind of Orthodox Christian faith. No, even though she gained prestige, she won't do it. I guess the Sinai will have multiple marriages, but they won't become concubines. And no, that faith, I'm not sure what that symbol of that faith is, it's obviously some kind of Indian Sanskrit or something. There's a Tengri. Tengri should accept. Oh, she's 19. No, that's the... Oh, she'll accept... Oh, she's 40. Oh, even a couple of years younger. I just put that off too late. And my work in Galan seems to have come to a fruition, my chancellor says. By bribing and cajoling, I managed to fabricate a claim. I leave it up to you, to use it or not. Yes, definitely. I will use it, presently held by the Emir Ramadan of the Makkad Emirate, and 109 gold and 100 prestige to get a claim on Galan. So at 794, I have 275 gold. It would be nice to have about 100 more, which I should have in 795. And I have a claim on Galan. Now I will try to get a claim on Tabriz instead of using the border dispute mechanism. I'm in the middle of adjusting my new sextants. I find my son, Alandon, fidgeting nervously. Hesitantly, he speaks, "Father, I can't sleep. Go away, I don't have a moment to spare. I gain more prestige. You are told to be afraid of the dark." He gets mad. Go away, I do not have a moment to spare. There we go. Good parenting, but I'm stargazing. And he has an opportunity to pick up a positive trait and learn something. There we go. After many years of observing the skies, I now understand so much. I'm satisfied with my progress and will conclude my research. It doesn't say I get a buff in the Hermetic Society. What do I get? No, the Observe Sky mission is still going. God, did I have three Observe Sky missions going all at the same time? Because I think I've successfully concluded two of them. Now I'll perform a scrying to see my future. Use some of my Hermetic knowledge. And have I predicted the traveling of a starfall? Wiping my brow, I go over the calculations once again. I get the same results again. It does seem to add up. I lean back in my chair. Judging from all the signs, I am fairly certain I know when this marvel will take place. Come the night, I will gather a crowd to witness it with me. This didn't work out the first time, but we'll try it one more time. As I place my hands on the sides of the scrying bowl, the surface of the water is perfectly still, yet it only takes a few moments before patterns begin to appear in the reflection, mirror images of the world, the past and the future. I take a deep breath to attune myself to what I am looking for. Battles to come, where my relationships will lead, and I want to know what will happen to me as Emir. I think what will happen to me as Emir is that might have some influence on my not dying. I see a storm, I can almost hear it. Oh, it is actually raining, but I still see a thunderstorm. Damnation, this is clearly a bad omen. Negative one stewardship, negative one learning. Well, that's not much of a scrying, but oh well. I suppose one gets esoteric knowledge of the occult and arcane from where one can get it. And it looks like Tabriz is probably the holding that's the superior one. It has more slots for progress, so I will move my chancellor to fabricate a claim in Tabriz. It would be nice to have claims and avoid the border dispute. Although I guess the border dispute costs 109 gold, but fabricating the claim is going to cost me 109 gold anyway. So it's the same amount of money, but it's the negative modifier that you get from the other Muslims. But again, I'm going to die soon, so hopefully I'll die before the Muslims take the revenge. And I'll bribe Sisi to love me long time more in the hopes that I can get a genius baby out of her before I pass. She has a learning of 26. Wow, that's pretty darn good. That would be a nice addition to the family bloodline if we could get some genius blood flowing in it. And primogeniture, I still need to change to late administration law, which takes 3 legalism, and the legalism right now is at 2, but I could upgrade it to 3 and spend those points. So I will spend those points to upgrade it to 2, and now it needs 600 more points to upgrade it to 3. As I enter my chambers, all of the work I have done in my spare time seems to have been cleaned up and put back. Books are neatly set in alphabetical order. Gemale Jaws was apparently cleaning earlier. I'll mess up her chambers. She may get conscientious. Cleaning is not my virtue. I'll see if she can get conscientious. Jemalaya is quietly cleaning her chambers after my episode in there. Seems like she is very thorough. She gains the trait conscientious, and she hates me. Negative 50 for 5 years. Oh well, I'll barely last 5 years anyway, and at least she's got conscientious. Our family has gained a trait, even at the cost of family unity. I'm doing it all for the kids. What I won't do for the kids. And this Zoroastrian revolution will preferably take... And a son is born! Oh, it's a grandson! So, I now have a grandson who is part of the Abbasid Imperial line. And what will I name him? What is... Norwegian for moose? Is it? It's not elk. I'm just trying to quickly look up Norwegian for moose. It's elg? Elf? Elg? Elga? Elkt? This will just take a quick second. I'm just trying to find out my different moose names in different languages. Not elf. Elk, which is moose in Norwegian. If there is just one Norwegian language, I assume it's... a few days ago, initiate Musha Lyddon told me that he had written a paper on Thurgic rituals and handed me a copy to review. Reading through it, it is apparent it could well revolutionize our understanding on the topic. Do I see fit to endorse it, however? Yes, I'm not a total jerk. If something is revolutionary, I'll endorse it. And besides, he might endorse my paper in return. So I have a son and a daughter, and a grandson. It's a grandson that I have. And I still am short one concubine. There's my grandson. And he's a Mizra, so Muslim opinion is +5 because he's a descendant from one of the Prophet's relatives. I'll give him a stewardship focus and a range of betrothal. Oh, there's a genius! He could marry a genius? Yes. We now have two potential geniuses in the family line, which is an excellent marriage. My dear courtier and sister in the Hermetic Order, Sharzad, has stepped forth with an idea for a ritual that might invoke the presence of a divine being. The prospect of petitioning the divine itself for knowledge is tantalizing, and the idea has therefore been received with excitement by the Order. The ritual will take place in a few weeks' time. The secrets of the world shall be laid bare to us. What if we anger the being? We should not meddle in the divine. Oh no, definitely divine ritual. I've got cancer. It's time to look for the divine, no doubt. Only divine intervention can save me. And the betrothal between young Elg and the genius, prodigy, is accepted. Initiate Mulajin paper that I endorse has been approved for publishing. Oh, and I gain one learning just for approving of a published paper. That's pretty good. And it's October 18th, 798. Summoning the Divine. The time for the ritual has come, and your order has congregated in a spacious room. Sharzad has provided you all with a new special type of incense that she claims is necessary to make the eventual connection with the divine being. An entity touches your soul, though you cannot perceive it with any senses other than your mind's eye. Divine, pray tell us of the operation of the sun, of the stars. O divine, pray tell me of the operation of the gods, and tell me of secrets hidden throughout the world. Tell me of the operation of the stars. Perhaps it will change my fate in a more hopeful outcome than it seems in the next couple of years. So it is 795. Can I last till 798? dog, October 5th, 797. The divine being has given me cryptic advice in the pursuit of astrology in many forms. I believe I've deciphered what it meant. I look forward to putting it to good use. Diplomacy plus one. The divine being has my total confidence. So that's increased my diplomacy to 16 and my learning to 16. For I reign with my council, that's 35 diplomacy and 37 learning and 16 stewardship and 25 intrigue. So I'm actually a pretty good leader here at the end of my life, even though I didn't really begin it as such. But with average counselors and a lot of events, I managed to build up. And it would be nice to have a concubine if I could find one, an attractive one, of the right age. She's of the wrong religion. They're the Tengri one. Oh, Sisi. Sikai. The air is crisp and the sky clear. The people huddled around each other to observe the nightly phenomena I had predicted. Not all are convinced of my promise. As the hour begins to slip away, I hear the skeptical mumbling. Then suddenly several ooh and ah take place around me, and people excitedly start pointing upwards. Across the dark heavens, a tiny speck of light is moving, a white trail marking its journey. This is a night that all shall remember. I gain the proud trait and 100 prestige. And I complete the mission Observe Sky, finally, and I gain 200 esoteric knowledge. And my court, Faramaz, has gained widespread reputation after working in my court. He's now a renowned physician. That's good. He can try to keep me alive. And Sikai is dead. That is why she is not suitable any longer for a concubine. Unless that's what you're into. Maybe, you know, to each his own. No, she's Muslim, she's metaphysic, she's Byzantine religion of some sort. No, won't be a concubine. My spouse suggested separate bedchambers after months of fights, arguments, and tears. Gained 2 prestige and 20 hatred. Let us rekindle our life. Gained 2 piety and plus 15. Let us rekindle our love. I'd rather not have my wife kill me before I accomplish becoming king. So I still have a chance to become king of Dalem. And poor CK is dead. She would have been 16. Would have made a pretty darn good concubine. So I think that's the last of the attractive women, strong women, as concubine. She's 48, 16-year-old, a shrewd 16-year-old, wrong religion. I don't know why I keep checking the the Islamic religions to see if there'll be a concubine. I just keep thinking that because there'll be multiple wives. There's one of the Norse religions, or Sumanoko, or the Russian steppe religions. There we go, some Tengri religions. Why won't she do it? Would be an infidel, but she's a Tengri, and she's 42 anyway, so there you go. And this one's 42 as well, and Tengri. Will she be a concubine? I thought some Tengri will. Yes, she will. She doesn't mind infidels. Why does this one? Oh, she's a courtier. She's one of my courtiers. That's why she'll accept me, despite my being an infidel. Oh. So Buddhists, I believe, are they open to being concubines? So now I have a claim on Galan, a kind of claim on Dahiyistan, and if only my chancellor would build up a claim to Tabrizi, then I could avoid the negative consequences. Oh, and a message from my liege. Well, it looks like that's probably wrapped it up for this episode. The war for the Kingdom of Dalan has not begun. It's 30th November, 795. And And yeah, thank you. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the subscribe button. Consider watching my other videos, and please consider following me on Facebook. Thank you for your time, and have a good day. My Facebook link isn't on the screen itself. It's in the comments section or the video description below. A couple of people actually asked me that. They sent me an email. So if you just hit the little down arrow in the description of the video, you'll find where my Facebook link is to Sir Moose Jaws Gaming. And have a good day.